what got me thinking about applying behavioral economics to the immunization decision was thinking about the tension there is, perhaps, for some parents between doing what's right for their child and doing what's right for their community, and that there is a concept that we've studied quite a bit as economists and behavioral economists called altruism. And so it's actually in traditional economic theory, we would assume everyone is self-interested and makes decisions based on their own interests, and there's no reason to worry about how their decision makes affects the rest of the world. But behavioral economists have shown, actually, well, if that were true, we wouldn't have philanthropies and we wouldn't have public organizations. But so there is some interest that people have in giving to others and helping take care of others, even strangers they do not know. So one thing I was sort of interested in is a concept called pathological altruism, in which you're actually, not only do you care about someone or other people so much, you may actually do it in a way that is perhaps so paternalistic or whatever have you, that it actually hurts other people. And so in the case of immunization, I've been thinking about, is this a case perhaps of pathological altruism where parents may be trying to help their children, and in that not causing them short-term pain in getting the immunization, or they see there are some potential risks of side effects and so they don't get the immunization. But in the long run, those small risks may be actually detrimental to the child's life. And so just sort of thinking about that, and that made me want to use economic experiments to sort of get in the mind of different parents and their decision-making processes to understand what might be guiding them in deciding to vaccinate their child or not vaccinate, or choose to not vaccinate for certain vaccines.